Hi there, I'm Janelle Marie. Welcome to Body Beautiful, the show where we talk with local professionals about the latest in cosmetic procedures and medical devices. With us today, we have our favorite plastic surgeon, Dr. Joseph Mele. We're talking about a bunch of different procedures.
Nice to be here.
First, I know we love you here. We're going to talk about breast aug, followed by rhinoplasty. Then we're going to talk about popular Brazilian butt lifts. And finally, thighplasty, which we haven't done in a while, and I'm very excited to get to. Before we get started, any advice we give you today, consult your own physician. All right, let's jump right in to the most popular, breast augmentation. Am I right, sir?
Still one of the most popular every year.
Exactly. What's going on new in the breast aug world? Are people coming in for bigger breasts, revision, smaller breasts? What's happening? Are we going more athletic or are we going bigger?
We seem to be more middle of the road.
Okay,
so
that's
not
good.
Not as many people coming in wanting to make a statement with their breasts.
Gotcha.
More filling their clothes, feeling proportionate.
I like that. So
yeah,
just kind of
like
evening everything out.
Because yeah. Right. I don't think everyone realizes if you're very flat before having breast augmentation, and all of a sudden you have, let's say, a D cup.
Exactly.
They can get in your way and limit your activities,
absolutely,
make it harder to run. But if you've never had it, like I've never had it.
Right.
I would never know.
You would never know.
But I don't want to find out afterwards. I'd like someone to warn me.
But it does take a toll if you're trying to exercise and
it
stuff
can.
And you have bigger breasts. And a lot
it
of people
can.
Come in to reduce them because of that. Am I right?
I do. I see women who are larger than D cups who have neck pain, back pain.
Exactly.
And they're just not comfortable. And they're much happier when they're reduced.
Absolutely. Let's get right to the pictures because people love the before and afters. And you can
sure.
see all these before and afters on Dr. Mele's websites, which I'll get to later also. But let's talk about the first picture. What did you do here?
So this is someone who came in perfectly normal breasts, mm-hmm. just wanted to be a little larger.
That's
and
cute.
She was concerned not only with the size, but the fact that the upper part of her chest is pretty flat.
Right,
so
it wasn't
it's hard
full.
To make cleavage,
mm-hmm.
it's hard to fit in some
mm-hmm.
clothes, there's a lot of gapping in the upper part of the bra.
Mm-hmm.
But she wanted to be proportionate.
Gotcha.
So what I've done is just put the breast implants in behind the muscle, which gives us that nice taper at the top.
Is that why behind the muscle does?
It does, because if
gotcha.
You're in front of the muscle, you
yeah.
tend to see that upper curve a little bit more.
You can almost see the implants, maybe.
Yes.
Ah, I gotcha.
And it's
okay.
always a challenge when someone's thinner to
exactly.
disguise that there's something there.
You gotta have a little meat on your bones.
Yeah. So the more stuffing, and of course, the smaller the implant, the harder it is to tell.
And so there's no scars here. I mean, I can't see them.
Well, I've gone underneath. So underneath
gotcha.
The inframammary fold, that little crease that's underneath the breast, I can sneak in there. And the nice part about that incision is it's good access. The hardest part for me is getting the bottom of that pocket made. It
yeah.
gives me direct access. I'm right there. And the same, and it also hides very well in clothing.
Yeah, and the after pictures are so natural and so beautiful. I mean, they're perfectly sized, I think. Trisha from Alamo has a question about breast aug. She wants to know if she can do more procedures during a breast aug, or do you just have to do the breast aug? We've talked about this a little bit before,
sure.
but let's talk about
well,
that.
Probably the most common one is the mommy makeover.
Right.
So we'll do some sort of breast augmentation or enhancement, lift, even reduction,
mm-hmm.
and then combine it with something that helps the belly.
So it's
okay. As simple as tummy tuck,
gotcha.
Do liposuction, or anything in between.
And let's talk downtime. Let's say you had to do a couple procedures. Let's talk downtime.
Sure. So downtime with this, it's sore. It's like you did a lot of push-ups.
Okay.
So most people, the first couple days, I've had patients, we weren't friends. And then by the end of the week, we're friends
again,
and all's forgiven. But I expect you to be able to have a little time where you can take care of yourself. So
gotcha.
If you're having to do a lot of heavy lifting, you're going to want to not do that for a couple weeks.
But then look at the after effect. It's beautiful. So it's worth it.
It's worth it.
Picture number two.
So also very similar. She had a little bit more of mm-hmm. sort of a cone shape to the breast. So we're
mm-hmm.
trying to round that out and make it more proportionate. Same issue with the cleavage, not having a lot of fullness. But again, not wanting to go overboard. In her case, her nipple was relatively low.
Yeah.
I did not do a lift, but I did lower her inframammary fold. And you can
oh.
kind of see that there's a little mole there off to
mm-hmm,
the right
mm-hmm.
that's below the breast
oh, yeah,
or even with
that.
The breast. And then afterwards, it kind of looks like it's been raised. Well, actually, the breast has been lowered.
That is beautiful. And do you use gummy bear implants or what's the latest implant?
I like these highly cohesive implants. Back before 1985, the implants
yep.
were almost filled with oil.
Right.
And when they leaked, the oil would migrate
yeah.
and cause trouble. Mm-hmm. With these, they're solid. Some of them, if you cut them in half, they stay as two halves.
Yeah.
And the ones that don't are still very cohesive where we don't have that gel migration problem like we used to.
Picture number three.
So here's someone want to go a little bit bigger, want a little more fullness up top.
Looks beautiful.
So we use a higher profile implant, which
gorgeous.
Keeps the breast narrow so it's not going off into the armpit and also provides more projection for the same volume.
And when you do a lift with a breast aug, that'll cause a little more scarring, but they'll still
sure.
fade, right?
The lifts, there's several types of lifts.
Mm-hmm.
The simplest one is just an incision around the areola. And
gotcha.
That's more for repositioning the nipple than really lifting the breast tissue. Others are the vertical lift or the full lifts. Those do cause more scarring, but they really help with the shape.
When you have to move the nipple around, do you get the sensation back?
It should come back. It's rare to lose sensation.
Okay.
The nerves, when reductions actually, we end up getting more sensation.
Really?
Because we've taken some of that tension off of the nerve.
I like that.
It's not removed. We don't take the nipple off and move it. We leave it attached to the blood supply and the nerves. Yeah, that way it continues to work.
But the scars are kind of like more a T scar?
They can be for the formal, the big lifts.
For the lift, yeah. Okay. And how do you know when you have to do a lift? You just, when they come in, like this last picture here.
You have to have sagging to need a lift.
Yeah, oh yeah, right. But I mean, you have to have pretty, you know, a lot of sagging, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Our final picture
here.
The
last one's really a revision. So this is someone who's had implants. The capsule around the implant got tight. It lifted the implant up, kind of distorts the shape. So that would be a grade 3 capsule. If it's tender, it would be grade 4. And what I've done is remove the capsule, lower the implant, and give back a normal, natural shape.
And I can almost see the implant in the before. You can almost see the outline a little bit. It looks so much natural in the after.
They become firm and they're not very mobile.
Okay.
So afterwards, you want it to be soft and mobile, like a normal breast.
And one last question, can mothers breastfeed after breast aug?
It's encouraged. Yeah, if you want to breastfeed, you definitely should.
It's okay, you can?
Yeah.
So good to know. All right, breast augmentation already down. For more information about Dr. Mele, you can call 925-943-6353 or check him out on the web at either drmele.com or sanfranciscobreast.com. We are going to be right back with so much more on Body Beautiful. Can't wait to get to the next section. That went fast, huh?
It always goes fast.
We just love when you're here. We'll be right back on Body Beautiful.
The information and advice given on this program is for general informational purposes only. For medical advice on specific treatments, medical professionals should be consulted. You should not initiate a course of treatment without consulting a qualified doctor. The opinions expressed on the program are those of the guests and not those of Cron TV, its management, employees, or advisors.